As 2018 draws to a close, what are the major trend lines in equity, bond, and money market fund investment? And are there any surprises in the data? ICI Senior Economist Morris Mitler offered some recent insight.
The big picture is that 2018 has been a good year for mutual funds and ETFs and their investors. Investors have directed a combined $150 billion in new cash to long-term mutual funds and ETFs. Equity markets around the world are up about 4%. That doesn't quite match last year's performance of 25%, but equity mutual funds and equity ETFs have taken in about $5 billion so far. And bond funds, despite the fact that interest rates have been increasing, have received new cash flows. We believe this is driven by demographic trends, such as the baby boomers as approaching retirement. They tilt their portfolios towards a greater percentage of fixed income investments.
The rising interest rate environment has also benefited money market funds.
Absolutely. As the yields on money market assets, such as CDs or commercial paper, have become more attractive, money market funds have taken in about $25 billion so far.
Can we break down the equity markets? What do you see in terms of the fund flow trends there? Markets have seen highs and lows this year.
It's true that there have been a couple of bouts of volatility in 2018, but it's important to recognize long-term investors frequently use the types of funds that we're talking about, and they may have an investment horizon that extends years or even decades into the future. Because of the strong influence of long-term investors, flows in and out of funds tend to be muted relative to the movements in asset prices.
Let's break down then the bond side of this equation. What do you see there?
It can be challenging to invest in bond funds during a period of rising interest rates, but long-term investors always have the advantage of being able to ride out the cycle. While the value of their bond fund portfolios may decline temporarily, they still generate interest income. In addition, as bonds in the fund's portfolios mature, the proceeds are reinvested in bonds that carry the higher prevailing interest rates.
So the long-term investor, the type of investor uses our funds, really is continuing to engage with both types of investment trends, equities and bonds, because they suit their needs.
Absolutely. Mutual funds and exchange-traded funds tend to be used by investors who are trying to save for some major life event, perhaps retirement, perhaps the purchase of a home or college education.
Last question for you. Any surprises in the data?
One thing that's been particularly noteworthy has been the strength of the flows into international equity mutual funds and ETFs. Despite the fact that world equity indices have lagged their U.S. counterparts, international funds have attracted about $88 billion so far in new cash flows.